I also stand here on behalf of my kura te tākina. Kura te tākina, I told you about Rangiti. Rangiti here, four wives. One of them was named Manua Kotokoto. The Manua Kotokoto came Kawatakuwara. Kia Tūtahi, Kia Tūtahi came Tamakāra. I was raised on the land of Tamakāra. And we still reside here today. From Tamakāri, Kotokumaya, Kia Tūrua. Kia Tūrua married a princess called Hinehoku. From Hinehoku we had to talk with our chief, Rangatira of Ngātmīkia. Kei hea ngā pukia, kei te roto imi ki te aia ihe ngā pukia ki aia kahuma. Kei roto ia tā wawa. Ngāti pukia resides at the lake Rotoriti, a small lake that was first seen by ihe ngā. One of his ancestors. Ngā kapiro ake au te tū, ki te uwhare, ki paurangu hoki a hau, a hau ke ka, te tamakaki ho hau, ki te rongo uwhare a te tākina. O ma whanua, ki te parahātea tō namana, ki a whakatau ki aitea, ki tūtai a haa.
Thank you. Kau karakter me noho nei. E te la natia, na ki piti au. Karamua mo kōreo, ka kutimi. E rātta, ia rātta una, e kini kua nora. He rā wa kura natia kia kōpia, kia kauti kērus. Koe e te la natia o kōmātau kura o hāta, pētera. Nā ki piti au kura mai. Mihi mai, mihi mai, mihi mai. E lua ngā tangata pērā e o koe ka tua o hāko pētera. Ara, o kauti. Tā kauti ka namutuna. E au ki tāna. Rāua, rāua. Nā rangatira kai arahi a mātou nā tamatari. Ko moe rāua i ai a nena. Nā reira ki a rātou. Koe mai. Koe mai. Koe mai. Koe mai ki te taha o te moana o kakumata ko moe. Koe se ima e te rangatira. Ka bigeat, ka tagiat. Kia koutou, kia koe rai te turuma ki e maere. Anei rā ko okura te kwama mai nei ki bene o ngā rangatira. Ki tēnei o ngā matamiri. Ko ta turuma i nei, e wai kātia. Me wei mea no ngā rangatira o te lōpū. Paka rangatira, i roto i ngā kautapa, wahine Māori, wahine katoa o te ao. O rātou e moana me ngā rāka. O koe tēnā e noho mai nā e mire te taumata, hei tu moa. Ka mihi mātau katoa kia koe, me tō kā hui, ka i tiaki o tēne o ngā tikanga o ngā kura. E mau nei i roto i eni o ngā tawira. Nā rei o kamihi atu kia koe. E tō rōku e noho mai nā ki tō tā. Ke pēhe atu ana e rongu atu ana i ngā kaupapa o tō wai atana. E whakanui rā i a koe. O rātau. O mō kai mahi e mā. Noho nei i tō tā. Nā rei o kamihi. Kamihi. E hara i te mea e atu atu kōre mōna e mō. E pēhe tatu wiri ka rā tau. E kōwhiti nei a mātara. Nā tīma nā. Tīma nā. Tīma nā pōtā. Tīma nā pōtā. Tīma nā pōtā. Kuri cha te mana o tātou mātou. Tā rōpami tērā tatu hauta mama i o i te o ngā wāhi no honga o koutou. Kei o tui te whare nei, e whare ana ma waiu o tātou mātou. Mai ana i tō koutou rāna ki te no honga. E tū no. I ngā kai hāpā i katoa, i roto o te ne o ngā kura o tātou. I ngā koutou. I ngā koutou. I ngā koutou. E huri au ki wene e noho noho nei. E pēne i au i hako pētera. Nohi nohi kauna na mātou, ko mātou ki e hia. E uru atu ki roto i te roo kūkāna. Nā reira a kōpō o rātou ki konei, o koutou ki konei. E pēne a rātou rātou nui ni kumhae. Nā reira ki nā kōtou. Kēnā rātātou. Tōku tītā ni tā. It is called multitasking.
Yeah.
of my kōrero is due. As I enter into this room, I felt the waiver of the ancestors are with us. I recognize the people that are in here, especially Ngātū Manapu Karurangi. The welcome really brought them all back, and the mihi that complemented their karana, especially to our esteemed visitor and visitor. I had the privilege of accompanying these wonderful people in here. I apologize in my mihi. I am now, how old I am. But this is my first time in Auckland's grandeur. I was educated at Soetoro-Ng College, a boarding school in those days that prided itself on its leadership, rugby, and Māori. They somehow go together, those three. But I wish to address Te Awa, Ngāti Tikiao, for welcoming us. I believe the welcome is for me, for our special honoured guest, Maya, to the great leadership of global women throughout Te Awa, throughout Aotearoa. And in conclusion, third form sitting in a row like here in this auditorium, I wanted to be in a kapahaka when we welcome people to our kura. We sit back there and we look and marvel at those senior leaders that lead us today. But I also add to that one day, these people will be there, and you will be here. That's our dream. And it's such a dream of accompanying people here today. Whai a me iti kahurangi ki te tūo hukoe mehe mauna teitei. See the aspirations. Look at that big moment. I teach te reo Māori to some people, and I use that for the poke quite a bit. But one of the ones I teach is this. When you say your mauna, does the picture of your mauna come into your head? When you say your mauna, where you come from, the Pacific or another place around the world, the picture has got to be in your head when you mention that place, because that is you. Whaia is kahurangi. Be humble about it, but be strong as in our hunters saying here. Nā reira, hoia tērā, te reo I hoko I saku kōrero. I wish to say thank you for bringing back the waiver of our tūpuna, mātua. I am a white heron only comes once. And it is a special visitor. And today, I might be called. A kōtuku had landed in amongst you. And it's such a privilege just to be with them today. Nā reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou. Apologies for my back falls on the guitar. I haven't played the guitar. Nā reira, tēnā koutou. 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 T
very much. Morena, wahine ma. And a few tāne. There's a few tāne among us. Thank you so much for that very warm welcome to your whare. We were in tears with that beautiful, beautiful waiata. Called Teresa Gatting Aho. I'm Teresa Gatting, and I'm here today as Chair of Global Women. Myself, Agnes Naira, the Chief Executive of Global Women, and the whole team are here in support of our special guest and our shared kaupapa. The opportunity for you to listen and learn from Dr. Mara Sotero arises because of the kaupapa of Global Women. We are on a mission. Really, I think it's a sacred kaupapa for wahine in particular, because it's wahine together, standing together, who will change the world for the benefit of all of us. And Global Women is committed to diversity in leadership in Aotearoa, New Zealand. Women and the intersectionality of all diversity and the embracing of te ao Māori as part of what it means to be a Kiwi, to be a New Zealander, to make the most of the opportunity that being born on this whenua brings us all. I was born in Te Whanganui Atara, Wellington, but I grew up in Rotorua, the land of the mighty Te Aroa. And today I live here in Tamaki Makaurau. We were so fortunate that Dr. Meyer was able to schedule a trip in to Aotearoa, New Zealand this week. But with the terrible weather that we had here in Tamaki and up in Te Taitokoro earlier in the week, we had to cancel our hui because it wouldn't have been safe for everyone to drive up on the road when the main road shut. We will do our hui at a later time. We have to be on the treaty grounds, on the sacred whenua, for that mahi. The theme of the hui was, and will be, when we reconvene, reimagining 2040 in Aotearoa, 200 years after the signing of this treaty, and 150 years since we won the right to vote as women. And I'd just like to remind everyone, in case you girls don't know this, that when women won the right to vote in New Zealand, first of all, they had male allies. Male allies in Parliament, it would have been impossible without male allies. Secondly, the right to vote was legislated for all wahine, Māori, colonial women, women born in New Zealand, all wahine. We were one of the first country in the world, but also one of the few countries where that happened. In many places, Indigenous women did not win the right for the vote until decades after white women. And I also want to acknowledge the amazing foresight of the wahine Māori who fought in their own Runanga for the right to vote, who saw, probably ahead of Pākehā women at that time, that it wasn't enough just to vote. One had to be able to be in Parliament. And that didn't come for decades after women won the right to vote. So here we are today at a crossroads where we have the power to make Aotearoa a better place for all of you, for all of us, and through that is a portal to lead the world. So that's the Global Women kaupapa. And in time, we hope we would welcome some of you as members of Global Women. But for now, and for this morning, I'd now like to welcome, to address you all, Dr. Maya Soetoro-Ng. Dr. Maya is a faculty specialist at the University of Hawaii in Peace and Reconciliation Studies. She's also a consultant to the Obama Foundation and in particular advises on leadership programs for girls in the Asia Pacific. She's been in New Zealand now for a few days, and she's been very gracious and flexible as events have unfolded, and her itinerary looks very different from what was intended. But we all must be flexible and fluid, and it does give us the opportunity to share this morning with you. So without further ado, Dr. Meyer, would you like to come to the stage and address us all?
I am so super emotional right now because of your beautiful waiata. To be honest, I was flooded with feeling. I was crying and having trouble stopping because I felt really deeply the aloha, even though I didn't understand all of the te reo Māori. I really was moved by the soulfulness and the power of your words, your voice, your visage, your stance. You brought a lot of mana, you brought a lot of heart into that sharing, and thank you so much for that. Thank you for the korero, for the robust welcome. Thank you to Teacher Jody, is it? Joey, so sorry. Joey, for bringing those words and voices together, for sharing with such such intention, the values, the vision of connection with global women, with mana wahine, with all of us across the ocean, as well as gathered here. I am someone who was raised by a powerful woman. I was, I didn't have, sort of the male voices of Matua and all of the extraordinary sort of grounding. It was really a woman's world for me, and my mother was someone who worked with women in microfinance, and they were makers of baskets, of puppets, of shoes, of rice paddy hats, chapping, we call them in Indonesia. I was born in Java. Do you folks know where that is? It's not too far from here. It's a big Pacific island in the archipelago of Indonesia. And I was born to this woman who would take me to villages all over South and Southeast Asia. And she said, if we support a woman in these village or cottage industries, then we help the whole village because of the reach, the power, and the nurturing that this single woman has in her character, in her disposition, and in her work. And she was right. So she felt that supporting these village industries was the way to keep the Indonesian economy strong. And she would have loved meeting you and seeing your energy and thinking about your role and your work and walk in the world, your voices. When she was dying of ovarian and uterine cancer, at the age that I am today, 52, she came to me and she said, I thought that I wanted to be buried underneath a tree where you would come and read poetry to me and tell me stories of your children. She said, but I've changed my mind. I want you to scatter me in the ocean. She said, because how else will I get to all of the people and the places that I have loved so much? And for her, the wahine, the moon, was the ultimate symbol of that. She said, wherever you are, the moon is the same. Whether you are on a fire escape in Manhattan, in the Indus River in India, whether you are in a school in Aotearoa or in Spain, you are looking on any given day at the same moon. And so when I look at the moon, I will think of you. You are bridge builders. You are standing at the mountaintop and looking down into more than one valley. And nobody is more powerful, nobody is more talented, more strikingly beautiful inside and out than you. So I want to take just a moment and ask you, in the tradition of Auntie Puanani Burgess, who lives in Waianae on the island of Oahu, where I sit and raise my children, to consider for a moment, as a global woman, connected with all these other global women across the waters and by the moon that governs the tides, to think about your gift. Makana, we say in Hawaii, right? What is your gift to Aotearoa? What is your gift to your community? To this hui, to global womanhood. And I actually would like for you to take 5 minutes and speak to the person next to you and share with them the story of your gift. And the reason is that I want you to own it, to feel it, and articulate it. So take a moment in silence first, in reflection, to think about your gift. When you walk in the world, let it be with humility, as Matua said, but also strength. Let it be with an understanding of your reciprocal obligation. In Hawaii, we say kuleana, right? You have rights in your community because of the responsibility that you take. And in owning, naming, and using your gifts, you will take the next steps to decolonize our world, to engage in restorative practices, to heal traumas, to find innovative solutions, and to make us all both weep and laugh with joy and exuberant hopefulness. So take a minute in silence, close your eyes, and think about your gift. Now turn to someone next to you and take 2 minutes each and actually share with them the story of your life. Thank you. so good at quieting. So when you think about your gift, I want you moving forward to think about how did you come by it? How will you use it? You know? How will you share it? How will you lift others up with it? Think about that pathway forward. As a professor in the Peace Studies Department, we define peace very broadly as inclusive of human rights and social justice, indigenous justice, environmental justice, right? It's negotiation and mediation, also personal peace. I teach leadership for social change and peace movements and conflict management and peace education. In all of these things, I always share the vision of washing our eyes. I was talking about it with the Global Women last night. In Indonesia, it's cuci mata. You know, say it with me, cuci mata. It means literally to wash the eyes. But in Indonesia, people will say that when they go window shopping, when there's somebody cute walking by, you know. But at the end of a long work day, you go and look for a beautiful vista. That's washing your eyes. But it's also something deeper. Washing our eyes is something that you helped me to do today with my tears. Washing the eyes is about seeing yourself and this moment in new ways. Recognizing the things that are important to do, say, and bring near you at the crossroads. Washing the eyes is about seeing the world from many perspectives. It's about seeing your own power and gift and naming it in new ways. You are at that critical juncture. It's time to wash your eyes. We all, post-pandemic, are seeing in new ways. The storms of the climate crisis force us to see in new ways. We have to build a beloved future that has not been named. We have to envision a harvest and then plant those seeds. You guys are really critical components of that. And I want you to see yourselves today, if you haven't already, as peace builders. Peace is not about some aspiration. It's not something that is soft or small. It is big, it's hard. And it is about being an upstander and figuring out where you can step in the river. We do a lot of sort of river of life, which helps us to consider, you know, on the left side of the river, I sometimes have students write down all the bad, sad, hard, traumatic, ugly, mean things that have happened to them in life. And on the right side, I have them write down all the good, beautiful, powerful, celebratory, successful things. And in the middle of the river, they put their kin, their community, their faith, their language, you know, the stories, the sweet aunties and uncles, the philosophy, the poetry of their life, the mindfulness, the inner qualities, all of the things that help them to get from the left side of the river to the right. You have so much talent, so many tools. Think about what you lift up in that river and how then you take that and utilize your gift, you know, in the world. This is about positive peace building, which is different from negative peace building. Negative peace building is not negative. It simply means the absence of acute violence. A lot of times when we look at the conflicts of today and the needs, we don't see obvious violence, right? We'll feel maybe microaggressions, we'll see the slighting, the ignoring, the invisibility sometimes that leads to the harm. So positive peace building is about repairing that harm, engaging in restorative practices where whether the harm is big and obvious and visible or invisible, then we come together and we think about how we are bringing our hands, hearts, minds, spirits fully to the task of healing and reparation and wholeness, right? So that we're each planting those seeds and then not only creating a big harvest, but nurturing that to sustain continued growth. So I want you folks to wash your eyes about yourselves in this moment and think about yourselves as part of a global family to which you bring your particular talents as well as your language, your character, your culture, your kupuna, in a way, tupuna. You know, and I'm really, really grateful to be your Auntie Maya. And I'm learning from you while I'm here, but I also hope that you know that I have your back. I believe in you wholeheartedly. With my mind and my heart, I will endeavor to lift up your stories and help others to see how truly powerful you are. I want you to hear from the CEO of Global Women, Agnes Naira. And I want you to really think of yourselves as the future Global Women in this group, but also, you know, just connected through that moonlight to all of these incredible women who have come before and who you will be good ancestors for. Agnes, thank you. Thank you for having me.
Look, by the grace of my tupuna, and under the mana of Te Kaia Te Whitu of Waimamaku and Nahupiana, I'm here today. I want to start, this might sound a little bit odd, but as I sat listening, I don't know how many of you know the Dr. Seuss books, but those of you that have little ones around you, and there's a book called Oh, the Places You'll Go. And as I sat there, I thought about this moment, and I think a couple of our speakers said it too. This time will never come again. We might all come back to this kura, but this moment and this event will never happen again. And I feel really, really humbled and really privileged to be part of this moment and this time with you. Look, I want to acknowledge the leadership of the school for having us here. I want to also take a moment to acknowledge the relationship between Joey and Anya, and that is why we're here, and I am really grateful. I know Joey through some other things. Joey, for those who don't know, is an old girl from Queen Vic. I sit on the trustee, as one of the trustees for Queen Vic and St. Stephen's, and I can promise you that we will reopen those schools. Talking this morning before we came here, and what I want to do, so part of my mahi at Global Women, and just to note that I feel really privileged to both lead and serve the work that we do. And so what's in front of us is about women in leadership, women on governance, and bringing to account the responsibility that our employers have in terms of the position of women in leadership. And we do that in a number of ways, but I want you to know and you to understand that it's not just your social or your political, but it's your commercial value that organisations are looking for and pay for. And don't ever, ever underestimate what you bring and what you will bring to workforces, to our economy. You will bring all of that. I have no doubt that you will bring all your cultural, all your social, and all your political mana to the table. I have no doubt about that. But never doubt your commercial value. I worked nearly 20 years in the tertiary education, and I reminded particularly our Māori and Pacifica students what that meant. So right now, in this country, we need you more than you probably need us. And that's really just my message this morning, is that just remember your value. Find your village. Find your peeps that give you that confidence. I met someone recently and she said to me, I just follow the energy. I encourage you all just to follow the right energy, the positive energy, because there will be enough of the other energy that doesn't give you mana. Follow, find the right energy, the positive energy. And I just want to close. Again, I feel really humbled to be here. You are what is our future. And we all believe in you. And I just want to say, so all love from Global Women. I want to thank those of us from Global Women and others and my small team that were here today. But again, to the kura, thank you. This is a really special moment. And like a speaker said before, you might, in your 20 years, I don't know if I've got 20 years, look back and remember this moment. Thank you.
Inga mana, inga reo, e rauranga, tirama, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. It's my great privilege to speak a little bit about the kind of threads that have been woven into this beautiful process that we've all been part of this morning. This all began, actually, with an invitation. So Global Women approached Whaia Joey to help us to build the foundations for the commitment that you've heard this morning going forward around te tiriti o waitangi, around the place of wahine Māori within the organisation. And so sitting at the centre of all of that is a waiata that your amazing kaiako Whaia Joey has created with inputs from all over the place. And I really mihi to the kahurangi whānau who I think have wrapped around this process. Whaia Joey is the genius at the centre of it. But there have been many other hands and voices who have been part of pulling this together. Whaia Joey and I sat down and talked about what Global Women was and what the aspirations of the organisation were. And Joey has created a waiata that really names some of the very important ideas that sit at the heart of Global Women. So it is with so much gratitude and aroha and aloha, respect, admiration that I want to acknowledge and mihi to Whaia Joey, who has made a thing of light emitting beauty. This waiata, which I'm hoping we will all hear this morning, is such a beautiful taonga, and I mihi to you, Whaia Joey. It's been such a joy to work with you on this.
Maya, that's your new auntie, and Maya, and so if you're the auntie, then hopefully your brother's the uncle. So anyway, so hey. Ka hoki atua hau ki hōku ki koitanga i rungi te mata o te whenua o Hawaii. He maha ōku ohana ki Hawaii, ki Kauai, ki Hoa. Reira rāku ni ona. I a koe tai mai nei te rā nei, ka hoki mahara ki ngā āki o kupuna, ngā kupuna o Hawaii arā ki a ka mea mea. Tai atu ki Rudi o Kalani. Ia o wai tuhi a mawatahi me tētai o ngā kumu, ngā kumu a ko kumu alohi lani tōna ingoa i tētahi wāta mō te Lini o Kalani Festival and Kauai Wokihanga Festival. So i haere rāta mātahi tētahi me here. So Maya, once again, aloha, mahalo nui loa. Okay, well, the song, and I just want to say to you all sitting here today, we're proud. I know our tūmaki and all of us are proud of just you and your grace sitting there like you always do. It's not a surprise that you're really good and sitting there, and I hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have in this time. The waiata is, Marie has really sort of pushed by Marie Flannery, pushed me to do it here because I really didn't want to do it in front of anyone. I get very nervous because it's in its raw state. So I think Anya has said a lot. Anya and I wrote the lyrics and then I've just tutu'd around with the music. It's in its raw state, and we've used about six people and then two aunties from the kaupapa, two aunties. They're so nervous, Agnes, they're nervous. And so, because you guys are here. But look, when you hear it, it's in English and Māori because it's written in Aotearoa, so we've added te reo Māori into the Pākehā version. But it's a global song, and it will go into, I've been talking with a few people in regards to wanting to lay the instrumental track and actually have Indigenous instruments of the world, some of them play at the beginning with perhaps some kupuna from Hawaii, Māori one, all around the world of great ariki, great māreikura, and you hear them at the beginning of the song. So you're going to miss all that, but I said okay. So it's not important whether you jam to it or not today, but just keep still and open your heart up to the flash words. For some of these girls here, I thank you so much, you girls who are going to come up, who struggled with singing English words with Māori. You might hear some of them, but hey, they'll get it. So, yeah, the song is called He Taonga Kamehameha, and Kamehameha in Māori is priceless treasure. Kamehameha is priceless, and taonga is treasure. And this is a gift to all women of the world to take your place, to stand up, and don't be afraid to maira e hine mā. Hine Ahuone is the goddess, our goddess, and it's all about, we must pay heed to Hine Ahuone. Tēnā koutou katoa. Let's go, girls.
Thank you. Thank you very much.